Now, you may have heard many people pray the prayer in Matthew chapter 6, where sometimes it's called the Lord's Prayer, sometimes it's called the Disciples' Prayer. It doesn't matter. It's the Our Father prayer. You know it. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive our debts as we forgive our debtors. And do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, now and forever. Now we need to understand that Jesus taught this prayer to people who were not born again. They were still spiritually separated from God. They were not born again, they were not new creations. And when he taught them this prayer, he was telling them about praying a prayer that for us today is fulfilled. Think about it. Our Father who art in heaven. Today, you and I are in heaven with the Father. The Father is inside of us. We are one with the Father. So he's not that distant God anymore. He's not the Father who is in heaven far away. Today, we are in the Father. Today, we are one with the Father. We are in Jesus, in the Father. John 14:23 also says so, that the Father and Jesus have made their home in us through the Holy Spirit. So we are not separated from God anymore. Hallowed be thy name. God's name is hallowed, and today we are called by the name of the Lord. We are called by the name of Jesus. Today we are one with Jesus. In Ephesians chapter 3, it says, blessed be the God and Father through whom the entire family in heaven and on earth is named. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. God's kingdom has already come when he came into our life, and today he is establishing his will in this world through you and me. God's will is coming to pass through the sons of God here in this world. As long as our feet are touching this physical world, are on this ground, we are establishing God's will here in this world. Philippians chapter 3 and verse 20 says that we are citizens of the kingdom of heaven. So we are already in heaven, living from heaven here in this world. Then it says, give us this day our daily bread. Ephesians 1:3 says that he has already blessed us with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places. There's nothing more that God is going to give us today. We have all of him. We have everything that we ever need. We will lack nothing. We lack nothing. Forgive us our debts as we forgive those who are our debtors. It says in 2 Corinthians chapter 8 and verse 9, it says that Jesus became poor so that we should become rich. So he took all our poverty on himself so that we can have everything we will ever need. We will lack nothing in this world or in the world to come. Where we are living in complete wholeness and fullness of life. The Holy Spirit is all that we need. We have everything of the Father. Do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. Well, James chapter 1 and verse 13 says that God doesn't tempt, neither is he tempted. And deliver us from the evil one. It says in 2 Thessalonians chapter 3 that God is faithful. He will not let any evil come upon you. That prayer that Jesus taught his disciples to make is a prayer that is fulfilled for you and me. So we don't pray a prayer that is already fulfilled. We live in the fulfillment of that prayer.